Hello children, this is Anindita Banerjee from India International School, Asansol. First of all, I would like to welcome you all to my online class of science of Standard 5. We will start with the first chapter. First of all, before I begin with the first chapter, you should be knowing the name of your science book. The name of your science book is Expanded Universal Science. And you should be knowing the name of the publisher also. The name of the publisher of your science book is Pearson. And the name of the author of your science book is Natasha Mehta. Now, I would start with chapter 1 of your science book. The name of the first chapter of your science book is More About Plants. Now, you have seen many plants of same type around you. Now, what makes plants increase in number? The answer to this question is due to the process of reproduction. Now, the question arises that what is reproduction? Reproduction is the process by which living organisms produce more of their own kind. I repeat myself, reproduction is the process by which living organisms produce more of their own kind. Now, I would like to throw some light on this. Now, from a potato plant, a potato will only grow. From a cucumber plant, a cucumber will only grow. So, this is what reproduction is. Now, we come to the second page of your science book. There are certain pictures of certain fruits and vegetables. Is it visible? Is it visible to all of you? Yes. Now I will be showing you certain fruits and vegetables which has been given in your science book. Now this is the tomato. Okay. Now I split open and you will find many seeds inside it. Can you see it? The small seeds over here. Okay. Now we have the cucumber. The cucumber, if I split open, also you will find many seeds. See, the seeds are visible. Can you see, all of you? Yes. Now we have a potato. If I split open this potato, there is no seeds inside it. Then I take the carrot. I cut open. See, no seeds inside it. Now I take an orange. If I peel it off, if I take, see, I'll find a seed inside it. See the seed? Is it visible? Yes. Now, plants are of two types. One is flowering plant, the other is non-flowering plants. Now, what do you mean by flowering plants? Plants which bear flowers. Plants which bear flowers. Can you see? I have explained you with an example. Plants which bear flowers are called flowering plants. Now, I have taken a coriander plant. This is a non-flowering plant as because it bears no flower in it. It is an example of a non-flowering plant. Now, we come to reproduction from seeds. Now, most plants produce or grow from seeds. Most plants grow from seeds. Plants produce many seeds inside it. As I have shown you earlier, this tomato has many seeds inside it. Okay. Cucumber has many seeds inside it. But only some seeds grow into new plants. But only, I repeat myself, but only some seeds produce into new plants. Okay. Now, do all seeds look alike? No. The answer to this question is no. I have shown you this tomato. The seeds are seeds, very small in size. The shape, structure and size is different from cucumber, see. And that of orange also. That of orange also. The seed of orange is, it looks like this. Is it visible? Yes. Now, today here in your chapter, I will discuss about bean seed. I will split open this bean and take out the seed from it, and I'll be showing it to you. See, I split open and I take out a bean seed from it. See, this is a bean seed. Is it visible? And it is the shape of a kidney. Therefore, it is called kidney bean shaped seed. Okay. Now, it has a thin outer covering. If I split open it, a thin outer covering is here. It is called the seed coat, and it protects the baby seed. It protects the baby plant. Okay. Now, if this kidney bean shaped is split into two parts, we find two seed leaves inside it. You'll find two seed leaves inside it, and it is called cotyledons. And this cotyledons, they store food for the plant. Okay. Now, between the cotyledons is the baby plant, which is known as the embryo. And this embryo has two parts, the baby root and the baby shoot. The baby root grows downward in the soil to form the roots, and the baby shoot goes upward and gives rise to stem, leaves and flowers. Okay. Now, as you know, that plant produces many seeds, but only a few seeds germinate. Now, what do you mean by germination? Germination is the process by which a baby plant or seed grows from a seed in the presence of water, air, and sunlight. If any of these three conditions is missing, the plant will not germinate. So, the three conditions which are necessary for germinations are air, water, and warmth. I repeat myself, if any of this condition is missing, if any one of the condition is missing, the plant will not germinate. I end my video today. We'll continue with the next video tomorrow. Thank you. Please revise the lesson from your science book, which has been uploaded in the website of our school, and certain question bank has been given, certain questions also has been given. Please try it out and try to solve it. Thank you.